Well, it seems to be one crisis after another. Kyle was ending up in jail, in the hospital. One time I got a call saying he was laying on the sidewalk in front of somebody's store, and I wasn't in Vancouver, so I was, you know, beside myself with worry, and it's just one worrisome situation after another. He was just placed in a housing situation that didn't have enough supports. It was sort of like he could get drugs on the same floor that he lived, so he could just wheel down the hall and buy drugs. And he was even trading food for drugs, so there was no way that he was going to stay clean in that housing situation. And well, he had some really bad infections in his feet, so he went into emergency, but he was very psychotic at the time. When I heard he had went to hospital, I was going to go and see what it would take to get him admitted for mental health issues, and he had already been admitted, so he's been there ever since. So that's been since August, and I'm hoping he will have supported housing that can take care of his complex needs in the future. Oh, he was a really outgoing, active little guy. He was full of life and fun. He kept me active because he wanted to swim and play tennis and go cycling, and yeah, it was just a delight to be around. The first year or two wasn't too bad, but then when he got into the addictions and the psychosis got worse, and very difficult and unhappy and miserable. Yeah, suddenly the friends disappeared. Very different person after that.